Jonathan Beasley, it is your 40th birthday. Happy birthday, baby. I've had the pleasure of celebrating 19 birthdays with you. The very first one was your 21st, when we went to that really cool Italian restaurant with GT and Kathy. I'm sure you remember how cool it was to listen to live Italian music and eat delicious Italian food. And I got to celebrate 19 birthdays with you. I can't wait to celebrate the rest of our lives of birthdays with you. And be really cool in 2 years when I'll have celebrated more birthdays with you than not. I love you so much. Put together a little video for you on this quarantine birthday season where we can't do a whole lot of big parties, but I got your friends and family together and we all have a little something to say to you. So I hope you enjoy. I love you so much. You're my sweetheart forever. I love you more and more every day.
Game face. Criss cross applesauce.
Now this is a story all about how our lives got flipped, turned upside down. So we'd like to take a minute, just sit right there. We'll tell you how we became friends with a guy with great hair.
Oh yeah. In Portsmouth, Virginia, lost in days, we were wandering around, trying not to get tased, chilling out, maxing, we thought we were cool, but this awesome dude was about to take us to school. He's strong and wise and always looking so good. He said, yo, come on over to my neighborhood. He said, what's your deal? I said, my lease is up soon. He said, you're moving in, kid, we got a spare bedroom.
You kick your butts at the gym day after day, and when we got back to the house, you have a lot to say.
He said, sit on down right here in my kitchen, now tell me about your goals and stuff, I'll listen.
First class guy, one awesome dad.
He said, never give up on those dreams that we had. We'd stay up late talking, no shirt required. Until we got tired. He works real hard, he's a jack of all trades, but has time for his fam any time of the day.
He taught us what's important.
Who's the best? That's easy.
It's the birthday guy.
It's Jonathan Beasley. Yeah. We love you, man.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday. Yeah.
Yeah.
Happy birthday, Uncle Jonathan. I just feel the big one. It's coming.
Happy birthday, Uncle Jonathan. I hope 40 treats you well, and I'm so thankful that I can call you my uncle and that you've been with me for so many years. I love you so much.
You know, there's many things I could say, but I'm just gonna say, well, I love you. So, number one, you know, basically all the lines to Princess Bride. I don't really know how it's possible, but you've somehow accomplished it. Yeah. Number two, you taught me to never give up. And I know with my generation, like, that's a really big issue, so. Number three, you taught me not to keep stuff in, and you taught me how to communicate better, which, that's always good. And number four, you know, there's that whole birthing thing, you know. I wouldn't really be on this earth without you. You know, you're my dad, so. Thank you. Anyways, I just want to say I love you and happy birthday.
Hey, Dad. How are you right now? Happy birthday. You're turning 40, you old man. Remember that time that you took... Well, I got in the driver's seat of your truck whenever you had it. And we drove onto a random guy's field. And I was really scared that the cops were going to come. But you just kept telling me, no, it's okay. I know these people. They don't care. And then a couple years later, we did that with Mom's Jeep. And I found out that you don't know them. That was pretty funny. But just want to say I love you. I really look up to you and how strong and how confident you are. I've been working on that myself, trying to get bigger, trying to get more confident, walk more confident with confidence and whatnot. I love you. Happy birthday.
Hey Jonathan, happy birthday. This is the Moogster, and one of my favorite memories of you is during a Thanksgiving dinner, you were over with Rachel, the family, and you were thirsty. I didn't have milk on the table, so you popped up. Went to the refrigerator and you grabbed a bottle of something and poured it into a glass and you took a drink. And your comment was, oh, that was really stout. Well, you were right, because it was not milk. You were drinking half and half, so I guess it was stout. And I see that every time I see that word stout, it always brings me back to Thanksgiving and your stout drink. Happy birthday.
All right. Hi, Jonathan. Hi, Rachel. We're here at someone's 40th birthday. We wanted to be safe, but also wish you a happy 40th. And we're going to toast.
Happy 40th.
Happy 40th. Oh, and now we have to break quarantine. From each other.
Just for a moment. Here we go,
just a second. There we go.
Happy 40th, Jonathan.
Oh, that is really good champagne. So good.
We couldn't get it to him.
Now we gotta drink the whole bottle.
We opened it, so this
all by ourselves.
It was really good.
But we'll be thinking of you on your 40th. Being a 40-year-old myself, I know how it feels. Not as good as 39, but enjoy.
Hello, everyone. I'm here on the Powers veranda, and the reason why is because this is a very special place in Powers history and in the history of Rachel and Jonathan. It was on this very veranda that Jonathan, in a very serious way, came to me and asked me if he could marry Rachel. Of course, in faith, I said yes, and I have to say that this place now is an important part of who we all are. We have even a poll here that has a growth chart of all the kids. Good things have happened here. But what I'm here really to say is happy birthday, Jonathan. 40 years young is pretty cool. Some people may even think you're an adult now. But, of course, I know better. God bless and thank you very much.
Hello.
Happy birthday.
Hope you're having a great day.
Stop stealing my line, Sorry. Aiden. No, but seriously, have an awesome day. I don't know if beaches are closed down there, but I hope that you find one and are able to relax. But yeah, have an awesome time. Bye.
Bye.
Mr. Jonathan Beasley, happy birthday, buddy. This is the new norm with social distancing, so to celebrate your 40th birthday, I'm sure you're doing it 6 feet apart from everybody else. And so I guess I'm doing it from Pennsylvania. So from one old guy to another old guy, happy birthday. Miss you. Hope you're having a good time.
Jonathan, I have known you since you were about 6 or 7 years old, and now you're going to be 40. You are the best uncle to Summer and Hunter, and I know they love you. And I love you, and I hope that you have the best birthday ever. I can't wait for y'all to come out and see the house. You're going to love it with everything we've done since you saw it when we first bought it. Happy birthday. I love you.
Uncle Jonathan. It's your nephew Hunter here. It's your birthday coming up. Yeah, I've been summoned to maybe say a little thing or two. No, seriously, I think it's a great idea. It actually got me thinking, what are the things that I would say in a birthday video to my uncle for his 40th birthday? One, you're not getting old. Because if you're getting old, that means I'm not too far behind, and no way in hell am I getting old. I'll be 33 at the end of this month. So that makes us 7 years apart. And we've mentioned it before about how, like, we almost felt more like cousins than uncle and nephew because of how close we were in age. We kind of, especially now that we're older, we kind of relate on a lot of levels, you know, growing up, like, I mean, there's a little bit of separation in our generations, but it's not much. It really isn't. And I think that's been really cool as far as how our relationship has been able to develop. So, yeah, I'm definitely grateful for that. I know I think all the time about how I used to play F-Zero and Super Nintendo and stuff. It would come out to your house in Hampton, and then more recently, you know, being able to have drinks together and, you know, talk conversations about, you know, all the things. So yeah, it's really cool that we've actually been able to do that, because we're like, we're on that level. Like, there's no filters. We can do that. Little Elijah Craig for you. But yeah, man, just wanted to get up here, say a few words, you know. I certainly appreciate your existence. I guess, like, I've always, of all the Beasleys, I've felt very much closer to you than really any of them. And again, that probably goes back to that age thing. And really, honestly, like, you know, of all of them, you kind of put on less of a front, like, and I can't even really say that they all put on a front, but you just seem more open, like you're more of an open book, like you're willing to share things that are like deep in your soul, like we talk about theology, and I don't think we've scratched the surface on politics, but like people's moral compasses and things like that, like the deep stuff, like that's really cool that we can do that. So anyway, I don't want to blab on for too long, but yeah, I wanted to give you some thanks for being and wish you a happy birthday. So yeah, here's to you, old man. I mean, not old man. Yeah, you're not old. Love you.
Hey, Uncle Jonathan, it's your birthday. I hope you party like it's your birthday. I hope you enjoy your quarantine birthday because, you know, it's just a great day. Happy 40. I love you, and you're the best.
Well, I hear you're 40. Not there in person to take one with you. So, I guess I'll just have to do two myself. Here's to 40 and living. Love you, mate.
Happy birthday!
Uncle Jonathan, today is the day that you turn 40. I hope you know how much you are loved, admired, appreciated, and missed. You and your family opened your arms to me and were my beacon during hardship. You continue to display true leadership and strength. I hope to one day give you the biggest hug. You are hands down one of the coolest uncles. I would say the coolest uncle, but hands down one of the coolest. And without a shadow of a doubt, you are one of my mother's siblings that I'm the closest to. I love you and I miss you. And I hope you have an amazing 40th birthday.
Hey man, dropping in to wish you a happy birthday. Big 40. It's a big number. Not that big. That's what she said. It's a good number. You're gonna rock it. Love you, dude. Miss you. Bye.
My uncle, Uncle Jonathan, also known as Uncle Gonison, further known as Uncle Kjarnison. I believe I made that one up, actually. So I take credit for that. This is for your 40th birthday, 1980, 90, 2000, 10, 20. Yes, 40th birthday. Which still seems pretty young to me. I don't know, I guess after being in the dental field and having patients who are like in their 90s a lot of the time, I start to see patients who are like in their 60s, they seem younger, and then patients in their 40s, they're kind of like kids still. So if that's any consolation, you're still young in my mind. Just want to share some memories. One in particular, because there's so many, I don't know if I could capture them all right now in this video. Just one memory I have from the Mountain View apartment. It must have been like 1996 or so, 97 maybe. I was like 4 or 5 years old. I was climbing one of the trees at the Mountain View apartment over by the cafeteria, the retreat. And I had climbed this tree dozens of times. I knew this thing in and out. I had no problem scaling this thing. Yet, I was climbing up to one point, and I was pretending to be stuck. And I have no clue why. I don't know why I would do that, but kids do weird things. So I was pretending to be stuck so that someone could come and rescue me. And you and my father were at the cafeteria at work, and my mother didn't know what to do, so she called, and you came over. I remember seeing you running up the field, coming over here to rescue me out of this tree. I have no clue why I was playing this prank of sorts, but sure enough, there you were, and you somehow got up there, and you helped me down, and I don't know, you just sent me on my way, and we were good to go, and that was the memory. And looking back, I try to think, okay, what was that? I don't know what to extract philosophically about that whole thing. I don't know what exactly I was doing or why, but one thing I've kept with me over the past 20 plus years of this memory is that you were present in my life. You were there. You were not missing. And it's a kind of thing in a kid's mind, having an uncle who's just cool, who's there, who's present, who's active, who's involved in your life. It's this thing that I think every kid longs for or hopes for or appreciates. And that was you, honestly. Of all the uncles I have, I think you're the one who just had the most impression into my moldable mind as a kid. And I just remember those days. And that one memory in particular just reminds me that we were family, we were together, closely knit, and we were involved in each other's lives, and you know, the joys and pains and beauty of all that wrapped into one thing. We had it, and we still do. And man, I just look back at that with fondness. So there's just one memory of many that I could share, and maybe we should get together sometime and talk about some of those things. Anyway, I love you. Happy 40th birthday. Still pretty young. No worries. Don't worry about it. There's lots to do. And we're going to do it. Love you. Peace.
All right, dude. We're trying to round up all 13 of these kids here to make this video for you. Because we all love you and want to wish you a happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
What do you want to say? Cameron's the oldest. Let's have Cameron start.
Okay.
My whole family loves you.
Aw. Jameson, what do you want to say to Uncle Jonathan?
I miss you.
Aw.
He also said that he remembers you being really strong. That's what James... Isn't that what you said earlier? Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Harper, you want to...
And Harper, what do you want to say to Uncle Jonathan on his birthday?
Pushing on me,
happy birthday.
Love you.
Say happy birthday. Okay. Yeah, happy birthday, Uncle Jonathan. You were always very welcoming to me from the beginning. Thinking back to those early days, you were there for my most embarrassing moment. If you forgot about it, even better.
He knows exactly what you're talking about.
I haven't gone water tubing in 12 years. no, but seriously, we love you. You're always so welcoming to us when we want to come down, even though there's a lot of us. You're always open to having us, and you've always been there for, I know, Michael especially, just with real estate and life and everything. We love you. Happy 40th. Sorry.
I'll just grab the phone. It's just easier. Hopefully the editor can like edit some of this crap out. You can't do it that way. You have to keep it this way. I wanted to say that there's only one, hopefully this isn't too public, but
There's only one uncle that I feel as close to as I do with you. I know that I can go to you with everything, that you know me better than most people in life. There are only a handful of people who really know me the way that you do. And I don't take that for granted. I don't take our relationship for granted. I care about you a great deal. I've looked up to you. I remember emailing you at like 16 years old and just talking about life and stuff, and that's never changed in the last, whatever, 15, 16 years. That hasn't changed at all. I know that I can go to you with anything, and I hope that you feel you can talk to me about anything too. You're a good man. I care about you a lot. I love you, and I hope to get together soon once all this craziness is done, and we can chat and connect, and we can get these families together.
Love you.
Love you. Happy birthday. Happy birthday.
Happy birthday. Happy birthday.
Love you.
So this is just crazy. How in the world am I wishing you a happy 40th birthday? It boggles my mind that we're at that stage, but happy birthday. I can't believe it's been 32 years that we first met. You were a little older than Cameron is now, and it's just crazy for me to think of 32 years gone by and just watching you grow into the man that you are now. I'm just so proud of you. You've always been there. Thank you for being a support to our sons, to me, my husband, of course, Joel, your brother. We just love you, and we just want you to know how much you're loved and appreciated. I hope you have a great birthday. I just wish we could see you guys more. I miss the times that we're not together, and I cherish the times that we are together. And hopefully we'll have a lot more of that and more frequency in the future. Love you, Jonathan. Happy birthday.
JB, 40, turning 40. Say it ain't so, man. Crazy. That was fast. That was a fast 40 years. I remember the day you came home from the hospital. Oh, man, you made me wait 10 years to have a little brother to beat up on and to break his guitars and all those kinds of things. And then the next few years, you played guitar for real and played bass, and you drove me crazy probably in those next few years. And then in your 20s, you had kids, and in your 30s, you started businesses, and you're a land baron and all these crazy things. But now at 40, as good as everything has been, dude, I gotta tell you, and I wish someone had told me this when I was turning 40, life can actually get better. Here's some of the things you have to look forward to in your 40s, man. For me, in my 40s, my kids got married. I started having grandkids. I have four now and got the fifth one on the way. My wife and I in our 40s started to travel more. We went to some cool, exotic Caribbean places. We went to the West Coast and Arizona, Utah, and California, and all these really cool places, man. And you and your bride have that to look forward to. Lord willing, and the creek don't rise, you're going to see some of that stuff and have some of those experiences. But life is going to actually get better. You don't just get old. And I mean, listen, you turn gray and you get some gray beard and you get some wrinkles and, you know, that kind of stuff going on. But you don't just fade into the sunset and like shrivel up. You know what I mean? No, we're Beasleys. And life is actually going to get better. I really believe that, man. I love you so much. And man, I just pray that your 40s are everything you would hope for, and I pray that you and I will get to spend more time together, have some more golf games, and have some more jam sessions and fun stuff like that in this next decade. Man, I love you so much and wish you a happy, happy birthday.